They always say in the comments, hey man, just install Google Camera, it will rip any photo taken by the iPhone. Well, Google Camera really does improve the picture on the phone. To be honest, I didn't expect this and I hurried to share this video with you. Guys, this is not a complete comparison of Pocophone with a Google Camera versus an iPhone XR. This is my first emotions, first impressions and first photos taken with Pocophone's Google Cam. Literally yesterday I installed it and I can tell you that it was not easy, or rather it was easy because it doesn't require root, but it was difficult to find exactly the version of Google Camera that would somehow work. All cameras start and freeze except one that I found, and still, after 3 photos, camera starts to freeze and it starts to work properly only after restart of the app. And if you are surprised that I compare $800 and $300, do not be surprised. I do not want to offend or praise anyone with this video, just let's look at the results and then you will make conclusions on your own. Let's go straight to the point. Let's start with daylight, and here you will not see the difference. The stock camera application, G-Camera and iPhone XR are showing almost same results. Details on photos are similar, and in my own opinion, I like mostly the photo taken from stock Pocophone camera. Well, we will not stay on the daylight photos for too long. Let's look only on another one photo because they do not differ too much, and we will proceed to bed lighting. The winter is really cold, as you can see. And about the photos, I can only say one thing, they are actually the same, both on iPhone and on Pocophone, only colors differ. Next. Now we look at slightly darker photo. Beautiful photo with Christmas light. The most realistic colors are on the iPhone XR. We zoom, and do you see it? Can you see the difference between Google Pocophone camera and its stock camera? When I saw it, I just couldn't believe it. The potential of the Pocophone stock camera is so unrevealed. Of course, the colors on the Google camera are oversaturated and absolutely unnatural, but details are awesome. And the photos are really not worse than on XR. Let's look at the next photo, street lights. Well, here photos does not really differ from each other. The only difference is this man in the corner. But if we'll talk seriously, the differences are only in the color reproduction. Other moments are very similar. Oh, and here is the shot that surprised me. Look at it. The stock Pocophone camera is much worse than Google camera. And yes, the iPhone XR is taking beautiful photos. They are just awesome and the colors are more realistic. But the $300 Pocophone's Google cam is definitely not worse. Okay, let's look at the fountain. All photos are good. Everything looks nice on all 3 shots. But in detail, the stock camera of the Pocophone certainly loses, especially on the left side of the frame. Everything looks blurry. And on the other side, Pocophone's Google camera again shows perfect results. Well, in the final night photo, in which Google camera confirms that it can shoot good photos, the dynamic range of Google camera is gorgeous. If you zoom and bring some objects closer, then these objects can be seen. While even on the iPhone, there are light points that are overexposure. Google camera is awesome. F1's stock camera photo compared to its Google Cam app is simply not as good. It would be very good if Xiaomi cameras could shoot such photos as on Google camera right out of the box, but they don't do so. And as we can see, the whole thing is only in the software. But everything is not so good with the Google camera. As I said at the beginning of the video, too many bugs and freezes. It can't be used normally because of it. And even in the working version, after the 3rd photo, everything slows down. But you can use it together with stock camera. For example, normally you use stock cam, but if you want to take nice photo at night, just turn on Google camera. Such video today. Thank you for watching, hope you liked it. My name is Eugene, if you didn't know. Subscribe to my channel if you didn't yet. And see you in the next video.